Hey everybody, how's it going? Happy lunch hour here on this beautiful Thursday. I'm really excited to share this story that I came across with you. This is a prophecy, a legend that's been passed down through the Achuar people who are located in the Amazonian rainforest in the Amazon basin, and I'm pretty excited to share it with you. So here's the little story, and then we'll talk a little bit about it. So the prophecy story relates that in the beginning, all the earth's people were one, but long ago they divided into two groups and each followed a different path of development. The people of the eagle were highly scientific and intellectual. The people of the condor were highly attuned to nature and to the intuitive realm. So the story goes on to say that at our current juncture in earth's history, and apparently this prophecy goes back thousands of years, the eagle people, the people of intellect and mind with highly developed sense of aesthetic and cognitive skills, will have reached a zenith in their amassing of science, technology, and technological tools, expression of high art, and the ability to build and construct. This will bring enormous, tremendous material wealth to the leaders of the eagle world. At the same time, however, they will be spiritually impoverished to their own peril, and their very existence will be at risk. So that's the eagle people. In the same era, the people of the condor, people of the heart, the spirit, the senses, and deep connection with the natural world, will be highly developed in their intuitive skills. These indigenous people will reach a powerful zenith in their profound ancient wisdom, their understanding and relatedness with the natural world and cycles of the earth, connection with the great spirits, the animals, and the plant kingdom. At the same time, they will be hungry and impoverished for knowledge and that will enable them to be successful in the material world, and they will be disadvantaged in their interactions with the material world of the eagle in a way that their very existence will be at risk. So both groups' existence at risks. And it goes on to say, neither the eagles nor the condors will survive without collaboration, and from a rejoining of these two peoples, a new alloy consciousness, I love that, alloy consciousness will emerge that honors the eagle people for their remarkable accomplishments of the mind and honors the condor people for the deep wisdom of the heart. Together and only together, the crisis will be resolved and sustainable future will emerge for all. I just came across this in a book that I was reading and really powerful story. So obviously, and if you're watching this on some form of technology, you are probably living in an eagle people culture. And we have tremendous power and resources. We just don't always know what to do with it. And sometimes that can show up for us as dissatisfaction or an inability to enjoy even the material wealth and prosperity that we have. Because often, even for many of us who grew up in religious or spiritual traditions, and even maybe still think of ourselves that way, sometimes we still can have this lack of a spiritual grounding in a higher purpose and what the meaning and purpose of all this stuff is. I know in my family growing up, we were not like wealthy by any means, but we were certainly comfortably middle class. And my father in particular was kind of racked with this guilt over what we had and what we possessed, because it's like, we have more than we need, what do we do with it? So meanwhile, you know, for many of us, many of the people that I talk with, the old ways of religion that used to provide that spiritual grounding and our higher purpose have kind of lost some of their power. Unfortunately, we're all too familiar with religious leaders or just outspoken people on social media offering, you know, judgmental attitudes and exclusion and condemnation as, you know, the voice of religion and spirituality. And if we don't buy into that, we're often told that we're going to hell, particularly in the Christian way this gets interpreted, but I think it's true in other traditions as well. And is it any wonder that people are not turned on by that? Or if they are, it's like your options are to just walk away or get sucked into kind of a fundamentalism, and that's just not appealing. It's not appealing to me, and it's not appealing to a lot of people in the world today. So, you know, if we just pay attention, part of the contemplative attitude in the world is like listening to what's going on in our minds and in our bodies. And if there's this pain around the material prosperity, the lack of clear kind of spiritual or religious connection to what to do with that or purpose, Within that, there's a longing. There's a desire to reconnect to our whole self, our whole selves. So in that sense, if we're suffering as part of this ego culture, we need the Condor. We need the unitive, the intuitive, the natural, and the mystic wisdom. For those of us in ego land, this journey to look for something more often starts by feeling and experiencing our own personal pain, often for years or even lifetimes, that finally get us to consider an alternative. So that can show up as this stress or burnout, this kind of like, why am I running on the hamster wheel every day? What, maybe I am successful, or I have lots of money, or I'm at least my needs are satisfied, but what's the purpose of all of this? And it can also show up as feeling just disconnected from your true self, like you're not showing up every day being the full person that you know has more to give or to be more connected. Feeling disconnected from God, or if you don't use that God language, from a higher power, a higher purpose, something bigger than yourself. Feeling disconnected from others, the people that you work with, the people you live with, the people you love, even we can feel disconnected from. And feeling disconnected from genuine community. Again, in days past, the religious traditions provided that in ways that many people just aren't finding it anymore. Or they are, but they're looking for something more, even as they are part of a church or spiritual community. And then feeling disconnected from the earth. We spend so much time in our heads in the ego culture that we lose touch with our bodies, we lose touch with the earth. If you listen to that longing, it will, if you listen and you stay with it long enough, despite the pain, it will draw you beyond yourself. Or we could say beyond your small self or your ego self. You'll see that that small self, that ego, is really an illusion. It is a false self, a false belief. Although that's painful to recognize this, that awareness, that recognition of that longing is a gift, and it's a gift that's actually pulling you towards a deeper kind of freedom that's possible. It shows you that we are meant to be part of a larger whole. That the only way to be free of your current pain and limitations is to give from what you have to the larger whole. And what the other piece that I love about this story is it doesn't say anything about the eagle being bad or wrong, or the condor being bad or wrong, right? It says both have gifts and both have needs, and they can only be met when we come together for the good of the whole. So it's not that having the brilliant intellect and material prosperity is bad. It's just incomplete. What do we do with it? So of course, in Eagle Land, we have developed these incredible technologies, economies, and material prosperity beyond any period in history that would have even thought imaginable, even 50, 100 years ago. It's not evil, it's just incomplete. And if we stay attached to hoarding all of that prosperity for ourselves, and there are plenty of voices out there pushing for that, for just our tribe, right? Or our, usually that shows up as our nation in the modern system, or maybe just our racial group, maybe directly or indirectly. It can become this precious metal that actually turns, that rusts and just turns into dust in the clutches of our hands by trying to hold on to it. While within that, we have the gift and we have what we need if we just open it up and share it. So, if we enter into, like following the story of that prophecy, if we enter into bigger exchanges of mutual prosperity, of expansion and growth, then we connect with the whole. We find that connection that we're longing for. We find the true purpose of our material prosperity that we have, particularly in Western societies. You can experience a kind of a sufficiency, a contentedness, and a centeredness, and a genuine abundance beyond what you ever knew was possible, and beyond just kind of, grabbing it for ourselves. Now, I don't know. Maybe you're watching this and thinking, "Okay, Tom, you've really gone off the deep end. Am I crazy? Am I just a foolish dreamer?" I don't know. Maybe, but I know that this is part of what just drives me to keep doing these and to keep doing this work and to keep showing up. So that's why I'm out here sharing the fruits of a centering contemplative practice with you. I think that's a doorway into that condor, that intuitive mystic side of who we are as humans. Because I want every one of you to, and all of us, to enter into that bigger whole together where true union, joy, and prosperity live. That's the crazy dream that I am gonna not let go of as long as I'm on this earth. If that vision is compelling to you too, and you feel that longing for freedom from the limits and anxieties of living in our eagle world, again, not because it's evil, just because it's incomplete, and you feel that pull to something more, then I genuinely want to have an honest conversation with you about how we can do this together. You know, just respond to underneath this video on the comments if this is moving something in you. It's all about engaging that conversation and building community so that we can all do this together. Beyond that, my offer and invitation is for you to book your free breakthrough session right now to see. We'll get on a conversation. I'm going to put a link to that here in the chat box. It's at thomasjbushlack.com/apply. Again, it's thomasjbushlack.com/apply. So my offer is to get on that call, and we will help you see where you're feeling stuck in the limitations of this ego world and discover what greater purpose lies waiting within to be tapped in that intuitive mystic wisdom that's there in your body, just waiting to be reconnected. And if we can help you get there and live that out, we'll discuss that with you. And if not, that's totally fine too. In fact, we will even look for someone else who can. That's it. It's pretty simple. So that's kind of my thoughts from this eagle and condor story and seeing where we can get stuck, where you might be feeling stuck in the limitations and of even great prosperity and wealth and wanting to connect that to something bigger. So go ahead and click that link right now or go to thomasjbushlack.com/apply, book your free breakthrough session, and we look forward to talking with you soon. Take care, everybody. Thanks.